Zebra mussels start their life as microscopic larvae that float unseen in the water. So anything that carries water, such as boats, trailers, bait buckets, and docks, can transport zebra mussels to other waters in Minnesota.
Adult zebra mussels can grow up to 1 to 2 inches wide. Despite their small size, these yellow and brown striped mollusks cause big problems. Unlike native mussels, zebra mussels have byssal threads, strong protein fibers, that allow them to attach to any hard surface.
Once they become established in a water body, they attach to boat hulls, motors, docks, lifts, swim rafts, water intake pipes, water treatment facilities, aquatic plants, and even native mussels. They can plug and interfere with equipment and water supplies. They can smother native species as they become a carpet of zebra mussels. Their sharp dead shells in the water and littering beaches can cut the feet of swimmers.
As filter feeders, zebra mussels consume plankton in the water, removing part of the food chain for native fish and animals. These mussels can increase water clarity as they feed, which in turn can cause increased plant growth. More plants can make boating, swimming, and fishing difficult.
Eurasian water milfoil and curlyleaf pondweed are two plant species that came from across the Atlantic Ocean. Since their arrival, they have spread to waters across the United States.
It only takes a small fragment of Eurasian water milfoil hitchhiking on a boat trailer, boat, or personal watercraft to start an infestation when it arrives at a new lake. It has currently been spread to fewer than 5% of Minnesota's lakes and rivers. Your work as a volunteer or ambassador is a key way to help prevent its further spread.
Eurasian water milfoil crowds out existing plants by growing up to 2 inches a day, much faster than the similar-looking native northern milfoil.
This prolific growth chokes waterways and fouls boat motors. It replaces the native plants that are the home where fish and other water creatures breed and live.
Curlyleaf pondweed is spread between water bodies by whole plants or fragments being transferred on boats or personal watercraft.
Curlyleaf pondweed grows under the lake ice in the winter, getting a head start on native plants. By blocking the light below, curlyleaf pondweed kills off Minnesota plants that are important to a lake's ecosystem. It forms dense mats in the spring that interfere with boating and water recreation. When it dies back in midsummer, dead plants pile up on shore, and they release nutrients that add to algae blooms.
Spiny water fleas are a tiny invasive animal that is less than a quarter inch in size. They also arrived from overseas in the ballast water of freighters.
The spiny water fleas will collect as masses on fishing lines, downriggers, anchor ropes, and fishing nets. They can start new infestations if a boater or angler carries such equipment to a different water body without removing them. Spiny water fleas will look like clumps of gelatin or cotton clinging to equipment.
Spiny water flea eat zooplankton that are an important food source for native fish. Because of the spines on the water flea, they are hard for small fish to eat, allowing more of them to survive and continue to outcompete native species.
Faucet snails have been an invasive species in the Great Lakes since the late 1800s and have reached Lake Winnebogoshish in northern Minnesota and the Mississippi River. They are less than a half inch in length and are hard to distinguish from native snails. Faucet snails are spread by being attached to water plants, boat and decoy anchors, boats, and other gear in the water.
The biggest concern with faucet snails is that they are a host for three types of flatworm parasites that kill ducks and coots.
Invasive carp include bighead, silver, grass, and black carp species. Individual bighead, silver, and grass carp have been caught in Minnesota in the Mississippi and St. Croix Rivers, and in one lake bordering Iowa. However, they are not reproducing in Minnesota yet, as they have in Iowa and further south. Black carp have not yet been caught in Iowa or Minnesota.
Please note that a statute change by the 2014 legislature makes invasive carp the official term for referring to bighead, silver, grass, and black carp, previously referred to as Asian carp. Invasive carp is the terminology you should be using as a volunteer who is educating about aquatic invasive species.
Invasive carp came to the United States for authorized government and commercial uses at research facilities and fish farms.
Bighead, silver, and black carp became established in United States waters accidentally during flooding of holding ponds into local rivers. Grass carp were stocked in many waters to control aquatic vegetation. Invasive carp can be spread by people transporting and dumping into the wild young carp that are used for bait. They can also be spread by illegal stocking.
Since they got loose in southern states, these fish have continued to multiply and spread north. In their native China, they live in a climate range similar to the United States's, so cold temperatures don't stop them.
Invasive carp feed on water plants, algae, mussels, and zooplankton, which are part of the natural ecology. Normally, these plants and animals serve as habitat and food for native species. Invasive carp can grow as large as 60 to 80 pounds, and their feeding causes major damage to rivers and lakes.
When spooked by sound or vibrations, silver carp can leap high out of the water. This has caused many injuries to boaters in highly infested areas south of Minnesota.
State and federal officials are working on methods to prevent invasive carp from moving up the Mississippi River and its tributaries in Minnesota. In June 2015, the Upper St. Anthony Falls lock was closed. This will help keep invasive carp from naturally spreading farther up the Mississippi River. However, careless actions by people using young carp as bait and dumping their live bait into lakes and rivers could still allow these fish to move overland into new rivers and lakes.
Unfortunately, these are only the top of a much longer list of prohibited aquatic invasive species that have gotten a foothold in Minnesota. Some of the other aquatic animal and plant invaders now found in parts of Minnesota are quagga mussel, rusty crayfish, New Zealand mud snail, banded and Chinese mystery snail, flowering rush, and purple loosestrife.
Other possible aquatic invasive species that have not reached our state are black carp, hydrilla, snakehead fish, and water chestnut. Any of these species can arrive at 55 miles an hour if they are carried on someone's boat trailer or in someone's bait bucket coming from infested waters.
There are also regulated invasive species that are brought to Minnesota as aquarium creatures, such as exotic fish, snails, and plants, as food, such as crayfish, and as exotic water garden plants. If these species get into the wild, they could become new invaders rampaging through our ecosystem.